Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 1st of January. India's health minister reviews dry run preparations for COVID-19 vaccination. Taliban says fully prepared for next round of talks for Afghan peace. And India rings in 2021 with revelry and prayers amid pandemic. And now for all the details. India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan on Friday took stock of the preparedness ahead of dry run for COVID-19 vaccination that will take place across the country on 2nd of January. Meanwhile, several states on Friday reopened schools from the first day of the new year 2021 as restrictions are being eased with the decreasing number of virus cases across the country.
Indian Health Minister Harshvardhan on Friday held a review meeting with the government of national capital New Delhi for the preparation of dry run of COVID-19 vaccination drive scheduled to begin on January 2. Harshvardhan, while attending the review meeting via video conferencing, informed that after training over 2,000 master trainers at the national level, the training for the vaccination process is underway at state and district level in over 700 districts. He stressed that the target of the dry run should be that minutest details are thoroughly researched.
हमारे देश में कोशिश हो रही है कि एक सेफ और इफेक्टिव वैक्सीन जो पूरी तरह से लोगों को कोविड से रक्षा करने में सक्षम हो वो जैसे ही देश के लिए उपलब्ध होगी. अभी आप जानते हैं कि दो कंपनियों ने रेगुलेटर के पास अपनी एप्लीकेशन लगाई है और हमें उम्मीद है कि अगर वो अप्रूवल उन कंपनियों को मिलेगा तो फिर आने वाले समय में जिस प्रकार का हमारा प्लान है उसके हिसाब से हम लोगों को वैक्सीनेशन करना शुरू करेंगे.
Meanwhile, several states on Friday reopened schools from the first day of the new year 2021 as restrictions are being eased with the decreasing number of COVID-19 cases across India, though concerns over the new UK strain prevail. India reported only 20,035 coronavirus infections in the past 24 hours with 256 new fatalities. The country also detected 4 new cases of the highly contagious mutant strain of COVID-19 on Friday, taking the tally of the new infection to 29.
Moving on. A severe cold wave swept through Indian capital New Delhi on the New Year's Day as the mercury plummeted to 1.1 degrees Celsius, the lowest in 15 years. A very dense fog also lowered visibility to 0 meters, affecting traffic movement.
Parts of northern India on Friday continued to experience cold wave conditions, with the temperature dropping to 1.1 degrees Celsius in Indian capital New Delhi, the lowest in 15 years. New Delhi witnessed extreme cold wave conditions aggravated by chilly winds and dense fog across the city. The India Meteorological Department said the minimum temperature registered in January last year was 2.4 degrees Celsius. Weather officials said the minimum temperature will start rising under the influence of an intense western disturbance, which will affect northwest India from January 2 to 6.
इतना तगड़ा कोहरा पड़ रहा है, पीछे से आया हूँ और मेरे को कुछ दिखाई भी नहीं दे रहा. अभी मतलब कि एक गाड़ी में टक्कर भी लग जाती. इतना भयंकर कोहरा पड़ रहा है D&T एक्सप्रेस हाईवे पे.
Meanwhile, air quality levels in the capital were also recorded at 426. In the severe category on Friday, according to the Central Pollution Control Board. According to the agency's Air Quality Index or AQI, any reading above 100 on a scale of 500 is progressively unsafe for health.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz Party Vice President Maryam Nawaz slammed Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government and said her party leaders are not scared by the arrest of Khwaja Asif. The remark comes as PMLN leader and former Foreign Minister of Pakistan Khwaja Asif was arrested by the National Accountability Bureau in Islamabad over allegations of acquiring assets beyond known sources of income earlier this week.
The lines of Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz or PMLN are not scared by the arrest of Khwaja Asif. Party Vice President Maryam Nawaz has said while slamming incumbent Prime Minister Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf government. On Tuesday, PMLN leader and former Foreign Minister of Pakistan, Khwaja Asif was arrested by the National Accountability Bureau in Islamabad over allegations of acquiring assets beyond his known sources of income. With his arrest, Asif has now joined a long list of PMLN leaders facing corruption cases, including party president Shehbaz Sharif.
Pakistan Muslim League Noon ke sheron ko dara loge to tumhari khayam khayali hai. Pakistan Muslim League Noon ke sher pehle se bhi zyada bahaduri ke saath aur dat ke tumhare zulm ka muqabla karenge.
This comes as the Pakistani Democratic Movement or PDM, an alliance of 11 Pakistani opposition parties, including the PMLN, has been holding anti-government rallies against the Imran Khan government on the charges of election rigging, corruption and dominance of the Pakistani army in politics of the country. The PDM has demanded the resignation of PM Imran Khan by January 31, and has announced a long march if he does not resign.
More on news from Pakistan. Hundreds of members of Pakistan's Hindu community on Thursday staged a protest demanding action in the incident of vandalizing of a Hindu temple in northwestern Pakistan this week. In the latest, more than 31 suspects have been arrested and a case has been registered against 350 people for their alleged involvement in the attack.
About 200 men and women from Pakistan's Hindu community staged a protest outside the Supreme Court Registry Office in the southern city of Karachi on Thursday against the attack on a temple. A mob in Pakistan's northwestern Khyber Pakhtunkhwa attacked and set ablaze a century-old temple on Wednesday, officials said, prompting condemnations from the Muslim-majority country's Hindu community. Holding banners and placards, the protesters demanded justice and punishment for the attackers. Reports suggest the attack happened after local Muslim clerics started giving provocative speeches during a protest against the alleged expansion of the 100-year-old temple located in Kirk district of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Pakistan has long been blamed for discriminating against its religious minorities, which is manifested in various forms.
Supreme Court iska somoto le aur jo sharpasand hai unko sirf giraftar na kiya jaye balki 295A aur 295B aur C ke तहत un par muqadmat qayam kiye jaye kyunki mazhabi aqliyaton ki koi bhi jagah ko musmar karna wo 295A mein aata hai.
Is mandir ki rehabilitation war footing ke upar hogi. Abhi mujhe Prime Minister sahab ka bhi message mila aur Prime Minister ki baat hui, Governor ka bhi mujhe phone aaya kal. मेरी शाह फरमान गवर्नर से बात हुई, चीफ मिनिस्टर केपीके से बात हुई, चीफ सेक्रेटरी से हुई, सारे लोगों ने हमें इस इशू के ऊपर सपोर्ट किया है.
इन द लेटेस्ट पुलिस हैड अरेस्टेड मोर देन 31 सस्पेक्ट्स एंड रजिस्टर्ड अ केस अगेंस्ट 350 पीपल फॉर देयर अलीज्ड इन्वॉल्वमेंट इन वैंडलाइजिंग द टेंपल. चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ पाकिस्तान गुलजार अहमद ऑल्सो ऑर्डर्ड अथॉरिटीज टू सबमिट अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव रिपोर्ट बाय जनवरी 4.
इन न्यूज़ फ्रॉम अफगानिस्तान. Spokesperson of the Afghan Taliban, Mohammad Naeem, has said his group is fully prepared for the second round of peace talks with the Afghan government, which are scheduled to begin from 5th of January in Doha. This comes as experts feared delay in the negotiations after a halt was declared in talks last month.
Taliban spokesman Mohammad Naeem has said his group is fully prepared for the second round of peace talks with the Afghan government set to begin from January 5 in Doha. Talking to Afghan media outlet Tolo News, Naeem said that the Taliban will return to what was agreed and the group has no problem to resume the talks. Meanwhile, the delegation representing the Afghan government in the Doha talks has also said that the Republic's team has conducted necessary consultations and will return to the talks at the scheduled time. This comes as experts doubt delay in the talks. The first round of talks between the two sides started on September 12 and went until December 11, 2020. On December 12, negotiators in Doha reported that both sides had exchanged their list about the agenda of the peace negotiations and that the next phase of the talks will begin on January 5.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Amid political unrest in Nepal after Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli dissolved the parliament, flag makers in capital Kathmandu are witnessing an increase in business as street protests have intensified against the move. Apart from flags of political parties, the demand for national flags have also increased.
As street protests have erupted amid political unrest in Nepal over the country's Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli's move to dissolve the parliament, Munni Shah is busy making flags that rise high during these demonstrations. Inside the streets of capital Kathmandu, Shah, along with her husband, daughter and two other helpers, is struggling to prepare flags for protests that are being staged on a daily basis across the country. After Prime Minister Oli announced the decision to dissolve the lower house of the parliament on 20th of December, cadres of various political parties who are staging anti-government protests have been placing orders to make flags for their respective parties. That has resulted into making flag making a flourishing business in Kathmandu.
अहिले त ठिकै ठीक छ अर्डर छ 10-12,000 अस्ति बेच्यो झन्डा अब यसले स्टकमा बनाएर राख्दै जान्छु अनि अब पार्टीहरू फोन गर्छ अनि लिन आउनुहुन्छ उहाँहरू अनि बेच्दै गयो बनाउँदै गयो
Shah said with elections announced for next spring, the business of flag making would further flourish in creating employment in the post-lockdown situation. Small-sized flag costs nearly 10 Nepali rupees in the market in the current scenario, which would continue to rise with the arrival of the election season.
People across India bid adieu to 2020 and welcome the new year 2021 by visiting beaches and rivers to witness the first sunrise of the new year and also paid obeisance at places of worship to pray for a better and prosperous year ahead. Have a look.
Indians visited beaches, rivers and temples on the morning of the first day of 2021 on Friday. People gathered near the gateway of India in the country's financial capital, Mumbai, to witness the first sunrise of the year. Similar scenes were witnessed at Howrah Bridge in India's eastern Kolkata city, where people also came to Victoria Memorial as the day broke.
2020 was a challenging year for a lot of us, but yes, it has taught us many lessons. It has brought all the families together, bonding, sharing, a lot of crises we faced together. So I'm sure God has given us a lot of strength to fight new challenges in 2021 and we all have become very strong people.
Some people also visited temples including famous Siddhivinayak Temple in Mumbai. And scores of devotees also paid obeisance at the holiest Sheikh's shrine, the Golden Temple, in Amritsar city, to pray for a better and prosperous new year.
हम शुभकामनाएं करने के लिए आए कि परमात्मा सबका 21 सबका अच्छा परमात्मा निकाले 2020 अच्छा नहीं गया अभी कोरोना से राहत मिले.
On the first day of a new year, devotees offer prayers at temples and river banks to witness the rising sun and take a dip in holy waters and start the new year.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.